Hey guys, welcome back to another video by Biology with Zhang Xuan. So today we are going to do a full experience video of me doing my IGCSE Biology's course. So this will be an A to Z with some tips which can hopefully score you an A star. So I hope you will enjoy this video. Okay, so this is an introduction. So of course, IGCSE biology is not for everyone. It may look as a very hard subject because of its long content, but it's actually not. And it is one of the easiest IGCSE science subject. If you're standing in the middle, that you think that sciences may be difficult, bio should be one of the easiest ones. It's paper 2 is very straightforward. It's just the MCQ paper, and the paper 6, alternate to practical, is also one of the most straightforward paper to answer. So if you're wondering how long is the duration of the course, would be about 2 years. So I studied from year 10 to year 11. And is it my favorite subject? Yes, of course, biology is one of my favorite subjects, and I understand it very easily when my teacher's teaching me. And the syllabus is, yes, I always printed out the syllabus every time I revise, especially the 2023 to 2025 syllabus. There is lots of changes and things removed from the syllabus, and I think it is very important. And how many papers am I going to sit in this exam? In this course, you will sit 3 papers. Paper 2, paper 4, paper 6. Paper 2 is MCQ, paper 4 is structured questions, and paper 6 is practical questions. And how many chapters are there in biology? There are about 21 chapters, and it's very long, but actually its chapters are like very small itself, so it shouldn't be very, very long like chemistry, like physics. And yeah, I will link all of the resources I use in the description below, and of course drop any questions in the comments, and I will definitely help you with my best of my ability. So here are my Zhan 6 tips to score A star in biology. So my first tip is the syllabus. Why? Because before revising anything, please print out the biology syllabus guide. It's super helpful, because what I've learned this exam is like, if I don't have the syllabus, I may miss out some key chapters. It's either that I don't have in my notes, or my teachers have forgot to taught me. When I look at the syllabus, I know what I need to study, and I will quickly add into my notes to make sure that I don't miss it when the exam question asks me. And notes making. Whenever you go to a class, like during year 10 or year 11, I always don't copy like whatever the slide actually gives. I always try to make short, compressed notes during class and at home at some time, and I usually will summarize it so it's easy to understand. And definitely you need to buy a suitable textbook if you have, and a textbook is useful to read and add to your notes, and this is the textbook that I use. So it's the Cambridge IGCSE Essential Biology 3rd edition, and I think this is very concise, it's not so wordy like any other textbooks I use, and this is definitely available, and I will link it below if you want to look it on this. And number 4 is past papers. Why past paper at number 4? Is because honestly, if you never even study, this past paper can already tell you how well are you doing. And past paper itself tells you like what kind of questions may come up. And please at least attempt 5 to 6 years of past year paper to get the feeling of it. All of the series, all variants, do not skip any variants. Don't say that because I'm sitting variant 2, I will do variant 2 only. Never do this. And read the mark scheme. I always think that reading the mark scheme is one of the most important thing in biology. Why? Because sometimes in your textbook, right, they only give a few points, but actually in the mark scheme, they give more than 6. And of course, when you look at the mark scheme, you will get more idea to what will come out. And that's why I would say, after marking your papers, read the mark scheme and the examiner report, so you can prevent that mistake and also add more ideas. And lastly, 6, make a mistake sheet. What I mean by a mistake sheet is that every time you have a mistake in any of your papers you have done, write it down in a Word document, the correct answer. And the example would look like this. So when doing my time, when I was doing my past year paper, I definitely will have mistakes. Don't think that because you score 100 or you score 90 plus, you think that you never make mistakes. And yeah, so you see how I make my, these are the mistakes that I made, and I write in a good document and print it out. So any mistake you make in the past quiz should write down the correct answer down in a Word document. Bold important keywords, you see, like I bold bacteria, don't have a nucleus, RNA and mitochondria. Copy paste certain mark schemes at the second one, you see the sustainable fishing. Look at it, there are so many ideas, and I always read it before and during my free time and before any of my assessments. And yeah, and I will link one of these examples. You should have a look at it, and you should, this helps to give you inspiration how to do this the same thing. Okay, next one. Four websites I use during my IGCC, and I think these four websites are probably the most sufficient websites that can actually make you understand the entire course. So number one is Papakrem Cambridge. So this website is not really a revision note website, but it's a past paper website where I source all my past paper. Remember guys, past papers are free. It's on the internet and you can get it. So there's examiner reports, mark schemes, and the question paper all available there for free. And here's the link. I will send the links all in the description below. Please have a look. And the second one will be ExamMate. ExamMate is whenever I have any topical assessment or term assessment in school, I will always use ExamMate to practice these questions. Or sometimes I will use Physics, Math and Tutor. I will also link these links below. Number three is Save My Exams. Save My Exams is one of the most popular ones. Notes website I have ever seen. There's a free and paid note websites where you can learn and add info to your notes. There's not just CIE, there's also Edexcel and AQA, and there's lots of subjects available, and you should definitely check it out. And number four is Znotes. Znotes is one of the free notes that is honestly available in the internet, and it's a student-based notes. So this website was completely designed by students who do this subject, and I'm currently doing it for chemistry. You should check it out if you're taking chemistry. I will link it down for biology here. Okay, next one. This is a biology past year paper routine. Why you must have a routine? Because it really shows you how are you able to set up your revision. And first thing is, at least 100 days before your first biology exam, your routine should work like this per day. I will do one biology paper 2 MCQ and one biology paper 4 structured. And sometimes I will do a paper 6 paper if I have time. And 3 weeks before your first IGCC biology paper 4 or paper 6 usually starts like this, you should double the amount that you have started during the 100 days program. Like example 2 paper 4 per day, because you follow whatever is going to priority, and you should adjust whenever you are doing this. And I always start from 2015 up to an ascending order. I know some people will go down the descending order, but honestly I find that going the ascending order, it prepares you to start from the most difficult one, then it brings you up much better. Okay, and these are the paper below, it's just an example. Okay, and take some time to read the marks in the examiner report when marking. So it's available in the websites that I have shown. This gives you an idea on how to improve and prevent. Remember to add to your mistake list. This is a very important thing, and it's not a burden if you're doing this. It's actually really worth it. The next one is knowing the assessment objectives. So starting this course, you are required to know these assessment objectives so you are very familiar with it. So it's AO1, AO2 and AO3. So AO1, this is about remembering facts and applying these facts to new situations. So in Cambridge, we do memorize in bio, but not all the time. You must know how to use your knowledge and apply it by understanding it. And AO2 is about handling information and problem solving. Usually it's all about graphs. Paper 6, practical question, they're giving you new situation and you are able to solve it. This is also same for AO3 together. And yeah, paper 2 is for 45 minutes and there will be an MCQ sheet given, and you need to manage your time well in paper 2, and it's usually at the last near when the exam series is over. And you are required to copy your answers from the question paper to the MCQ sheet within that 45 minutes. And paper 4 is 1 hour 15 minutes. Usually it starts at the first or the second in the exam series. And the structured questions contains, basically they're going to test you everything, whatever is in the syllabus. sometimes it may come up cold topics, like maybe like plants. Some of the hot topics would be one of them, like the humans, the reproductive system, and all those. And paper 6 is just 1 hour only. And to be fair, this is a very skill-based. If you practice more paper 6, you will get there are some repeated questions in there sometimes. And it's a very simple paper. You just have to follow the instructions. And some general exam and revision advice here. So exam stress is a really real thing, and especially handling other subjects in IGCSE also. However, I walk a different path than most of my friends. Maybe some of it are the same, but I find this really effective in my part. So remember, it's working smart and not working hard. Why do I say this? Is that because there are people who are working up late at night, thinking that working late at night will give you more value, but actually it's not. More about the quality that you are giving. And revision should begin consistently 4 to 5 months before the start. Do not procrastinate 2 months before the exam, 1 month before the exam, even though it's proven that it's possible to help, but actually it's not going to do much. And 4 to 5 months is the most optimal time to prepare. And read the syllabus closely in the 2023 to 2025 syllabus. There are some things that are removed and added. Keep an eye on it. Really, you have to really get close to the syllabus. It's gonna be one of your close friends. And watch YouTube videos of different channels in IGCSE Biology. I even watch my own videos during my revision. So this is a way to pick up strategies, okay? And lastly, that's why I say don't stay up late. A consistent schedule with a revision timetable with a small little break. I always follow the Pomodoro technique, where I do a study session one time and then get some breaks between it, and it really helps to adjust the way how I handle my workload, so I don't really feel really that stressed during this exam. And yeah, here's some advice that's given by Cambridge. Just read on this, test yourself, make sure you define scientific terms accurately. In this bio exam, you must know the terminologies really well. Do not give any, if you try to make any like sentences out of the word, remember the terminologies. And then have a look at past paper questions and see, that's one of the key things in the mark schemes. And during the exam, you must plan your time accordingly. Look at the details on how to answer these questions. Do not leave out no blank questions in the exam. You must fill it in, because sometimes even not filling it, you might, and a random answer will definitely get you a few marks. Just think hard and you will get there. Identify the common words, which you get there later on, and look at what is needed, calculators needed. Remember, in this exam you will calculate a magnification question. And lastly, common words, you must know how to know what it means by calculate, comparing, defining, describe, determine, evaluate, explain, give, identify, outline, predict, sketch, state, suggest. So have a look at this one. You must be clear in knowing what are these commands words, because they are the ones that tells you what to expect from your answers, not to give more than that. And always follow the marks is given, and that's how it really helps to guide your way there. And lastly, always believe yourself, because I know that you can do it. It's not difficult. You need to persevere, and in the end, it will definitely be one good reward. So I think shouldn't be a really big moment. I hope this really motivates you and, you know, start to work on for your upcoming exams. And yeah, see you guys next time. And remember, I will drop everything in the description below, and any question you have in the comments, you know. So see you guys. Bye bye.